How do you replace a receptacle the right way? All right, so this video is kind of for the DIYers. Now, I know electricians are probably gonna hate this video because it's teaching DIY people to do electrical. I get it, I don't like doing that, but I figured at least if they're gonna be doing this stuff, they need to have a video to watch that like talks about the safe way to do it, because we all know they're gonna do it anyways. So for all of y'all, even if you're just an apprentice and you've never installed a receptacle before, this video is for you.
The first thing that we need to do when we're gonna change out a receptacle is deal with the fact that it's probably on. There's a couple of different methods or things like testers that we use out in the field. Pretty wise for you to have some test equipment if you're gonna be doing anything with electrical work. And a lot of the testers and things that you can buy are really cheap. So I definitely don't think you should be doing work unless you have test equipment as well. So one thing that you can do is take a plug tester or a receptacle tester. This is not called a plug, this is called a receptacle. This is a plug, a plug plugs into a receptacle. Anyways, we still call it a plug tester. Plug tester shows you whether or not power is on. So right here, you can see that these two lights are on, and if you look at the little diagram on it, it actually says correct, like these, it's showing that this thing is wired correctly. So the cool thing about this kind of a tester is that it will light up in certain ways depending on if you wired this thing wrong, like if you got the neutral on the wrong side or you put the ground on the wrong thing, it'll show you all that. This model actually has a button as well to test whether it's a GFI circuit. This is not a GFCI circuit, so the button's kind of meaningless, but I think everybody should have a plug tester if they're gonna start doing any kind of electrical work, electrician or non-electrician. The other thing that you can use is what we call a tick tracer or a sniffer. It's actually the NCV on this means that it is a non-contact voltage tester, meaning it doesn't need contact for it to detect voltage, which it would be arguable that it's actually detecting voltage. It's really not detecting voltage because voltage is a measure between two different things, between one thing and another thing. So technically, I'm not gonna get into the mumbo jumbo, but anyways, this isn't actually showing you anything. You stick this in and it starts beeping at you. Sometimes if you push these down a certain way, it'll go without sound, but it'll still light up. So you have to be careful. Sometimes these can hurt people because they don't really know how they're how they work and when you should use them and when you shouldn't. Sticking this thing in doesn't actually mean anything. It means that there's a presence of power, but it doesn't tell you really anything that's going on with this. So it doesn't tell you that there's 120 volts. It doesn't tell you maybe there's 240 volts. It doesn't really tell you anything accurately. And sometimes these things lie because they're using capacitance. It's this thing called capacitive coupling, and it's sensing something, but again, I just don't recommend anybody ever use these tools except for electricians. And even when electricians use them, I tell them you need to understand when to use it. It's not to verify power, it's just to detect whether or not there is the presence of power available. So when I stick this in, the hot side of a receptacle is always the small one. The big side on the left is always going to be your big one. Older receptacles are not always going to be that way, but the hot side, just remember, is always going to be on the right side. Now, the third tester that you need to have when you're messing around with electrical stuff is an actual multimeter. This is kind of a multimeter. You can call it that, but it's actually called a tester. This is an electrical tester. People call this a multimeter because there's multiple different things you can test, but a multimeter has way more options than this. So this is a tester. So the other way that you can test power is by going to voltage, the V, and sticking it one in the neutral and one in the hot. It'll give you, this says 126 volts. You'll probably get something 118-ish, 125, like anywhere around there. Not everybody's power is gonna be the same. So in my area, I just happen to have 126, and I have a three-phase commercial environment. So typically my voltage is gonna be a little bit higher anyways, but still within the 120-ish range. I always check from hot to neutral, like you just saw me do. Then the next thing I do is test hot to ground. I should get the same number relatively. There's 1 volt difference, that's not a huge thing. And then the last thing that I always do is check the voltage between neutral and ground, and it should be 0. If you get a number, especially a large number, there's a problem there. So those are the three things that I think everybody should have if they're gonna be working on electrical equipment, even if you're not an electrician. All right, so the first thing that I need to do is I need to go and figure out which breaker this is so I can turn it off. Don't ever work on electrical circuits live. Always, always go shut them off and verify that they are indeed off. All right, now that my power is off, this is safe to work on. I'm taking my plate off. Now you're gonna notice here in a second that there is a metal box around this receptacle. Again, I'm in a commercial environment, so you know, I have a metal ring around here because we use metal boxes in commercial environments. So yours might look a little bit different than this. You might have a plastic box, but that's okay. Now I'm using a screw gun. You could call this a drill, I suppose, but it's only got one speed. It's specifically just meant for taking screws out of things and putting them in things. I have tons of drills. I just like how this one's really lightweight and small, and I can carry it in my tools. And then I pull out the big boys for the heavy duty stuff. Now what's different, you know, if you're doing this in a house, you're probably not gonna have a blue wire. You're gonna have a black one, or maybe a red one, depending on what kind of circuit you're working on. But you will most likely have a white on the left side, either a black or a red on the red side. And then you might not have a green wire. It might be just bare, again, commercial with our the type of wire we use, there's gonna be green sheeting on it. So the bare wire is always gonna be the one that goes on the green screw or your ground screw. All right, first thing that I do is I loosen up all my screws, start with my hot side. Then I'm gonna go to my neutral side and then my ground. I do it this way instead of doing each one at a time because I'm gonna change tools and I don't wanna have to keep changing tools over and over. Next thing I do, you might not even need this needle nose, but I like to just handle things with the needle nose. It gives me a little bit more precision. And sometimes these suck to get out of here, so it just gives you a tool that's like really easy to kind of manhandle the wire. So once I get that off, I'm gonna grab my new plug, my new receptacle. All right, so I've got a new receptacle now. You'll notice on a receptacle that you've got like a silver side and you've got a gold side. Gold side always means that that's your hot side. The silver side means that that's your neutral side. So a lot of like light fixtures and things like that, attic keyless fixtures, they're gonna have colored screws like that. If it's not identified as like an H for a hot and an N for a neutral, just know that your gold side is gonna be your hot side. Your silver side is gonna be your neutral. So I'm gonna go and put my ground on first. There's not really, it doesn't matter what order that you do these in, but I always recommend that people do it the same every time. One of the things that I do when I'm when I put my wires on is I like to squeeze it a little bit so that way it doesn't just come off if the screw's loose, it just hangs onto it a little bit better. The other thing is making sure that it screws around counterclockwise. So as I tighten, righty tighty, this is actually gonna bite that wire down more. If I were to put this on, say the opposite way, as I tighten the screw to the right, it's gonna wanna open up that wire. So I always flip it around and make sure that as I go clockwise, as it tightens, it's gonna pull that wire closer together. I always close the other one as well. You don't have to, but since I've got a metal box, I don't want anything extra metal like sticking out that might hit that box. Now notice too, I'm not crushing that wire down all the way. I'm just biting it a little bit more because I also want it to sit down neatly inside of this little like rectangular area back here. I don't want it hanging off the side out here. Then tighten that side up too. One last thing that I like to do is I just like to make sure that it is hand tight. So I'll go in here and sometimes drills don't get it all the way tight. Just make sure that it's snug. Then you saw at the beginning of this video that there was electrical tape on the receptacle. Now, if you're in a residential environment, you don't have to worry about this. You got a plastic box. If this touches the plastic box, nothing's gonna happen. I just like to do this in commercial settings because again, there's people that will come behind you and they won't turn things off and they'll try to work on stuff live. And I think just trying to like think about the person behind me, I like to put electrical tape around the studs, around these terminals, just in case somebody tries to pull this thing out hot. It gives like a layer of protection. That way, if it's hot, and it hits that metal, it's not gonna short out and cause an explosion. Not a necessary step, but you're gonna see some of these things that you take out, you're gonna wonder why there's tape on them. You might even see it in residential and they just didn't understand. Again, a lot, it just comes from people trying to do work on live circuits, which again, I never recommend that you do anything live unless you're trained and you have years of training on how to work on electrical circuits and you know how to work with live circuits with PPE, hot gloves, you know, insulated screwdrivers, things like that. So for most people, 90% of people out there, don't do work live. All right, then I just tighten it back down. I make sure that the top of these ears on this yoke or strap, that this little metal part is called the yoke, or sometimes we just call it the strap, mounting strap. But I make sure that the ears are flush with the drywall. I don't put this screw in so tight that it sucks it into the wall, because then you'll never get your plate to sit on there straight. It's always gonna be like kicked off to one side. So let me not put this in all the way. And you can see that there's still a gap there. So when I go and put this thing on, it won't sit. There's a gap back there. And no matter what I do, that's not gonna sit down flush. So it's always really important to make sure that you screw it in all the way. Another thing that helps too is to try to get the screw in the center of this little rectangular hole. So instead of it being off to the side like that, I make sure that it's in the center, and that guarantees that those ears are gonna sit down flush and nice and even. This one's a little loose on the bottom, so I'm just gonna go a little bit tighter. And last thing we do is put our plate back on. Now this plate looks like it's crooked, so take a little level, figure out if it is or not. Sometimes you can kind of move the plug back there. If you put it too tight, you're not going to be able to do that, but you have a little bit of flexibility in being able to kind of bump it, and now that is level. So that's it. That's how you replace a receptacle.
All right, my friends, I hope you gained something from that and got some value out of it. Electricians, I hope you don't hate me too much for talking to the DIYers. Again, honestly, I think just everybody knowing how to do this the right way and not getting hurt, and what the testers do and the methods behind it all. And I think it's just something that's needed. So I put a video out there. Love you, crazy people. I'll see you in the next one.